take a look at adding or subtracting rational expressions. So rational expressions, sort of a strange word to many people. All it implies is that we have an exponent on the bottom, is that we have a variable, sorry, on the bottom. So like this is the very simple kind of rational expression. Here would be a more involved rational expression. So these are both rational expressions, simply meaning that there's a variable on the bottom of the fraction instead of just on the top. Now, if we wanted to add these two up, just like any time we add fractions, we need to make sure that the denominators match up. So we're going to have to get a common denominator here. So the common denominator, just like, you remember how if we do 2/3 plus 3/5, one way to get a common denominator is to say, well, 3 times 5 is 15. We're going to do the same thing here. We're going to say x times x plus 1 is going to be our common denominator. So I'm going to multiply, so I want to get, in order to get that common denominator of x times x plus 1 here and here, just like you would with a normal fraction, you say, what do I need to multiply by here? What I'm missing is this part. So I'm going to multiply the bottom by that and the top by that. So what do I wind up getting? This times that is this. That's why we did it. 2 times x plus 1 is 2x plus 2. You distribute. Plus, now here, I already have this part. I just need that. So I'm going to multiply the top and the bottom by x to give me this. X plus 1 times x is that. On the top, I get 3 times x is 3x. Now, just like normal fractions, just like adding normal fractions, you carry the bottom over. This is your common denominator. So it's x, x plus 1. And the top, just like normal fractions, you add this plus that. So we're going to collect like terms. 2x plus 3x is 5x. And then the 2 doesn't have a common term, so we just copy it. Final answer of this rational expression plus this one, 5x plus 2 on the bottom, x times x plus 1.